and Wilpa will call. And evening is night, I hurry to my blue heaven. You turn to the right, you find a little bright light that leads you to my blue heaven.
G'day, welcome to My Blue Heaven. It is around about 10:45. As you can see, it's all done and dusted here at Marvel Stadium. I'm in the control box right at the top here. It's a lonely place at the moment, Marvel Stadium, and the roof has just been opened after it's been closed all night. And what a disappointing night it was for our football club. I think the loneliness of this stadium at the moment really sums up my somber mood after that performance. Really disappointing after, look, a good couple of weeks. I've misread this game. I was really confident that we could get the job done tonight. On paper, with talent, I thought that we probably had the edge. But I also said in the preview this morning that it would come down to an evenness across the board. And I thought St Kilda, full credit to them. You got to take your hat off to the opposition, and tonight they were far the superior side. And whether that was our poor performance and our lack of application and intensity in that first quarter, in that first half, they're just some of the things that we need to take into consideration. But you take nothing away from St Kilda. We're unable to control their speed of ball movement and the way they wanted to play on in that first quarter. It was really exciting to watch. They really did outnumber us at the contest and opened us up. And we weren't able to defend that speed. We looked slow. We looked reactive. And there were a couple of some real significant symbolic moments in that first quarter, which set the tone for the rest of that first half. And obviously the skipper from St Kilda, Jaron Geary, going to Sam Doherty, we knew it was coming. And disappointingly, I didn't think there was much of a response, particularly from our back six, in regards to really helping Doherty in regards to just a physical presence. The St Kilda forwards were happy to, really get stuck into him even before the opening bounce, and that set the tone. I mean, Geary was on fire in regards to really trying to stamp his imprimatur on the game, and he was able to do that. And that was a significant moment in that first quarter, and really disappointing, I thought, our physicality in that regard. I thought, we'd come sort of a little bit over the last couple of weeks in that regard as playing part of a team and being a collective unit. And I was a little bit disappointed with the likes of, Tom Williamson, Lockie Plowman down there, even Liam Jones and Jacob Wiedering weren't really physical and weren't willing to get over to the skipper and give him a bit of a chop out. Liam Jones did a little bit of it. I had the perfect view of our back half up here in that first quarter. Jones tried a little bit, but the rest of them, it was very meek and accepting of the fact that, the skipper was down, and St Kilda really owned us in that first quarter. And the other significant thing was obviously the centre bounces with Marshall, who I thought was wonderful tonight on Pitnet. Pitnet had not a poor game. I thought he battled hard, but he was outclassed tonight by a really good young ruckman, who's a really exciting prospect. But that's not to say that it's curtains for Mark Pitt, isn't it? I mean, he's very early in his career. What's he played, 11 or 12 games? So, he's going to come up against, blokes who are probably a little bit more advanced than him. And tonight, as much as he tried, he still won the hit-outs to advantage. And he had the five tackles. He got in the way a few times. I thought Marshall was a huge factor in the outcome of this game. And the other thing in the centre was the performance of Jack Steele, the former Giant, who let's face it, so just a, he's a really blue collar midfielder who just seems to have the edge over Patrick Cripps. And he's 9 disposals, 3 clearances, 3 tackles in that first quarter compared to Cripps's 3 disposals, no tackles and 1 clearance. It was really significant. And I spoke in the preview about one of my key focuses of this game was to see Cripps go out and be really physical at the start of the contest in regards to his minders. Now, he only had steel for company at the stoppages tonight, and I didn't see it once. I didn't see any physicality from Cripps. I thought it was just a really, really disappointing display by the captain. And I know, he's done some wonderful things and he's carried this football club for a long time. But I think sometimes, you know, that's the second week in a row now that he's been held. And he needs to work through that. I know he lifted after half time and he kicked a wonderful goal. But frankly, the fucking damage had been done in that first half. And, I was sort of bitterly disappointed in 1, his leadership in that first half, and 2, his physicality. So that was a huge win for St Kilda. And as I mentioned, we just weren't able to, you know, defend that sort of manic sort of ball movement of St Kilda. And they got goals from the most unlikely sort of sources. You know, Big Max King, who's a young developing tall, sort of had a little bit of a breakout game tonight on Jacob Wiedering, just had the better of him. I know he only had the 5 disposals, but he kicked 2 straight and always looked a threat in the air. So that was significant as well. And when the ball did sort of venture into our forward half, which it did on a few occasions in that first quarter, I thought our forwards were really flat-footed. Other than Eddie Betts's, you know, goal in that first quarter, which was a wonderful snap, I thought his game was ordinary in regards to his defensive pressure. Gibbons had a poor one with his defensive pressure, and he's been in relatively good form. I thought Cunningham took a step back tonight in regards to, you know, he laid the 4 tackles, but really he didn't provide any type of spark in that first half. I thought Sam Philp, you know, once again, I mean, he brings Philp in for that defensive pressure and he lays 1 tackle for the night. And you don't want to heap too much criticism on a youngster. Kicks his first goal tonight and picked up 9 disposals. But essentially he's brought in as that sort of forward who's going to provide that sort of manic type pressure. And we weren't able to do that in our forward half. And not to forget tonight, guys, the really, really poor performance of our key 3 talls. And I know the ball movement, I know that the kicking side forward 50 wasn't great tonight, but I just thought the 3 of them just didn't work hard enough. Mackay, gee. Harry's, he's got a long way to go, Harry Mackay. And eventually it's gonna click for him. We hope it is, but on tonight's performance, I'm not quite sure what we've got in reserve in regards to a key forward, but if he dishes up another performance, and I know he hasn't had a lot of continuity at the start of this season, if he dishes up another one like that, you'd be nearly considering bringing a Tom DeConning in just to give him a go, and maybe gives Harry an opportunity to go back and find some form, because he was ordinary. His body language at the time was poor. Levi had a poor one. He just didn't kick straight and he couldn't mark the ball and gave away some sort of silly free kicks as well. And Gov was terrible, you know, other than setting up a Nunes goal. It was just a really ordinary night. I think he gave away a goal on the goal line. I think that may have been in the first quarter. Look, right across the board, that first quarter, down by 30 touches, inside 50, 13-8. Wilkie was magnificent across half back. And Nick Caulfield, I'm not quite sure who was manning up those two boys, but they had a field day in that first half. Caulfield was really impressive for the Saints tonight. I spoke about Marshall. Look, small little wins for us. I mean, Hill had no influence on the game, but he didn't need to. I think he was carrying an injury, just didn't seem to be running across the ground. And I know Murph at times had him and a couple of other players sort of ran through Hill. He didn't have a huge impact. Billings kicked a really important goal. For the Saints just before three-quarter time after a really ordinary turnover by Sam Petreski-Seaton in the middle of the ground, where we did have some ascendancy in that third quarter, where we could have got that margin back to, say, three goals. It was a really significant moment in that third quarter. I'd just quickly like to talk about that third quarter because at least Teague tried something. Cripps full forward, Doherty on the wing. Was a little bit more successful, and I thought we started to outnumber them at the contest and got the game on our own terms, but it was just really, really sort of not a great system tonight. We never looked dangerous inside our forward 50 other than, you know, Will Setterfield popping up for a couple of nice snaps, but there was nothing conventional. There was nothing conventional in the way we played tonight, which I thought was a real step back to what I'd seen, particularly in the game against Geelong. And we never really controlled the ball for any significant periods of the game. Quickly run through the plays in regards to how I thought they went. Cripps, shocking first half, but lifted after half time. I'll give a more comprehensive ratings and comments in a document which I'll share on my Facebook page and also my Twitter account during the week. But I just thought, with Cripps, the damage had been done. He needs to be able to work through a tag. I'm not quite sure why that same level of intensity that he showed in that first quarter and in the last quarter wasn't shown in the first half. And you've got to see it. I mean, you've got to be critical of every player on the list. I'm not going to take it easy on Patrick Cripps just because, you know, he's the co-captain and he's been such a wonderful player. That's 2 weeks in a row now, and he was the same against Melbourne as well. Very poor early on Clayton Oliver and lifted after half time. You can't be playing like that, okay? You need to be putting, I mean, he's a leader of this football club. He needs to be stamping his authority on and leading from the front, and he's not doing that at the moment in first quarters. Doherty, the same. I thought, you know, like he lifted a little bit on the wing, but it was a poor night for Sam Doherty. Beaten by Geary. Looked a little bit flat, a little bit tired. I don't know if anyone else noted that. Maybe it was just because he'd been belted and pushed around and there wasn't a lot of support there. Simo was okay down back. I didn't think Loney, although Butler was quite dangerous. I didn't think Loney had a huge night for the Saints tonight, although Butler was a handful for our small forwards. I thought Jack Martin was quite clearly our best player for four quarters. In fact, I thought he was outstanding tonight, Jack Martin. He was good early. He supported our back six. He was hard at the contest. He showed a lot of courage. And he genuinely used the ball well. See, he only had the 19th disposals, but ran at 90%. I thought he was by far our best player. Curnow had Seb Ross, which was interesting. You know, I was quite surprised by that move. Ross ended up with a 21. Thought Ed battled on, but it wasn't a great game. But Ross didn't have a huge impact. So whether, you know, it wasn't so much that St Kilda's midfielders were that dominant. It was just the fact that they just had a better system and they played together better as a team and they moved the ball really quickly. And we were caught on the back foot. Plowman, yeah, look, I probably thought it was one of his better games for the year. So I didn't look at it closely. He had Jonathan Marsh, who was a bit of a decoy inside St Kilda's forward 50. I mean, he had a couple of Plowman moments, but I thought, you know, to be fair, I didn't really see a lot of huge mistakes by Lockie Plowman tonight. Murph, didn't think it was a good game by Murph. I know he had Hill and Hill was quiet, but I thought he backed out of a few contests tonight. And I thought he looked a little bit flat as well. Jack Nunes, so-so. I just think he needs to do more. I know he went back. You know, there was that situation in the last quarter where he was back and that he was the spare in defence. And it was a mung ball coming inside our defensive 50, but he didn't trap the ball. It went past him and St Kilda scored a goal and that was it. I thought Liam Jones, I know he had two howlers and you've got to judge a player on obviously coughing up a couple of goals, but I actually thought he was our best defender tonight. Thought he battled away pretty well. He took 11 marks. I think about five of those were contested. And I thought he kept Tim Membry pretty quiet. I know Membry popped up with a goal, but that wasn't his fault. That was a goal from long range, a bit of a snap. I thought he kept him pretty quiet tonight. Membry's been a bit of a thorn in our side. So, yeah, look, he made those mistakes. Sam Walsh, yeah, battled tonight. No tackles. yeah, it was a step back after an encouraging performance last week. Didn't use the ball that well. Thought it was a pretty ordinary performance. Setters had a wonderful third quarter. Good to see him get on the scoreboard, but didn't touch it in the last. Was quiet early. It was okay. Not great. Cunningham, quiet. Disappointing game. Gibbons, quiet. Disappointing game. Jacob Wietering, beaten by a youngster. First time he's been beaten this year. I don't think, you know, look, we've got to cut him some slack. He's had a fine start to the season. Sam Petrescu-Seaton, this is an interesting one. Are we going to persevere with him as a defender? Has he got the ability to defend? It's an interesting one. Ollie was ordinary tonight. Really ordinary. I don't know how I feel about that at the moment. I'd like to have another look at the game, but I just thought he's, you know, and he had that really bad kick as well. It was shocking. Didn't like his game tonight. Although, you know, he had Butler. Butler ended up with 2-1. Yeah, I didn't like, sorry, Petrescu-Seaton. You're a little bit of a worry at the moment. And I know they're trying to develop him into the defender. And hopefully with time that's going to work. But well, I'm not quite sure whether he has got the capabilities at this stage to be a defender. And it's a matter of whether we continue to persevere with that. Williamson had an off night. He tried a couple of things, but it just wasn't his night. Dropped an easy mark, fell over a couple of times, got caught. But he'd be better for the run. I was actually expecting that this might happen with Willow. You know, I mentioned Philp. You know, like, good on the kid. Kicked his first goal and got involved a couple of times. So I was actually a little bit surprised in the end when Fish went out that Philp came in. I thought it was a good opportunity maybe, and I understand the pace of St Kilda, but I just thought maybe Kennedy's physicality, particularly with knowing that, you know, they'd have Steel and they'd have, you know, Sebros and, you know, Hatterbury and, you know, big sort of bodies, Gresham around the ball, who were quite physical. And I thought it was an opportunity to give Kennedy a go, but they went with Philp, so that was okay. Betts, ordinary, 2 in a row now. And I said last week we might expect sort of dips in form at his age and where he's in his career. But that's 2 in a row now. So I'll be keeping a close eye on that. He was wonderful against Geelong, but that basically is, out of the four games he's played now, that's three pretty ordinary ones. I know he kicked a nice goal, but there was nothing. McGovern, ordinary, shithouse. Casbolt, shithouse tonight. Pitnett battled, but was well beaten. And Mackay, dreadful. So all in all, guys, a really disappointing night. As I said, I'm not going to flip and flop. I'm not going to, you know, go crazy and call us pathetic and we're not going anywhere and blah, 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 blah. Because the last couple of weeks I've been really positive. I come into the game really confident. It hasn't worked out tonight. We've got a big opportunity now to get on a plane, go into a hub and get back, get back on the board and play some better football. But I think on tonight's performance, I'd be really disappointed if some guys underneath aren't given some opportunities now. I'm talking about Lachie O'Brien. I'm talking about Kennedy. Obviously Fisher will come back in. He was out ill, possibly De Conning. So because we can't have these types of performances again. We had it against Melbourne, had it against Richmond, we've had it again now with a similar type lineup without possibly some changes being made. Whether we go with that same lineup again next week is very questionable, but I'll be willing to make some changes. I just think there's some blokes there who are waiting for something else to happen, and are too happy just to let others do the work, particularly early in the games. And that's the most disappointing thing about tonight. I don't think I've got much more to say tonight other than keep the faith. It's not all doom and gloom. There's a long way to go in this season. It would have been fantastic to go 3-2. Full credit to St Kilda. They were better than the team tonight. I still think we've got enough potential and enough talent to, you know, and that's what makes it disappointing. It was only 6 months ago that we'd stitched them up at the MCG in that game. And I'm not taking any excuses about, you know, they're a better team here under the roof than us. So there's a fucking load of garbage. So I'm not going there. It's a step backwards. There's no doubt about that, but it's not the end of the world. So please, you know, take a chill pill this weekend. Maybe switch off. Don't watch any footy. I know I'm going to have a bit of a break and I want to really think about this. In fact, I don't think I could go actually watch that game again, to be perfectly honest. So I'm not, as Dennis Pagan would say, throwing the baby out with the bathwater. I'm sticking fat. I saw some positives over the last 2 weeks. Tonight was no good. But, you know, let's be realistic. We're not quite there yet. We're a mid-range, sort of lower end of the ladder type team at the moment. And we've still got a lot of work to do over the next, over the course of this season. But, you know, let's keep the faith, guys. But obviously, if we dish up similar performances over the next couple of weeks, then further questions need to be raised. I'll see you guys next week. Check out my Facebook page, My Blue Heaven. Check out my Twitter account. I'll leave a link so you can have a look at my match comments for each player and ratings and a season leaderboard and all that stuff. That will probably be up maybe one Monday of next week. I'm going to have the weekend off, guys, and I'll see you again shortly. Not quite sure who we're going to play. The AFL have announced that we'll be going into a hub, whether that is, I think, South West Queensland or South East Queensland, I think I read somewhere, or New South Wales or Western Australia, I think was the other hub. So just a matter of time where we're going. All right, guys, catch you later. I'll see you again soon.